Hi everyone. Today we're going to play nice in Battlefield 1. Not the easiest thing to do, but one of the more fun things to do is to play a combat medic. And by combat medic, I simply mean I am not going to use anything but the healing syringe and the med packs here. See? Med packs. Now no one's hurt right now, so those won't do me any good, or well, them any good really. But we're going for it. And Conquest on ARRAGONE FORREST really lends itself to playing medic, and I was kind of lucky to get this role here. Simply because, well, I thought I was going into the end of a round. But ARRAGONE FORREST has only one vehicle available to it, and that's the train that comes rolling in about midway through the game, depending on how scores are going. And it's a pretty compressed map, so people are usually on just a certain set of paths. Which means I'm going to earn a lot of fucking points just walking around throwing out med packs. Like that! Okay. Yeah, sure, it was 1 point, but look. Look, friend! Friend! Come back! I'm going to die a lot. I mean, yeah, I just died there once, but get ready. By the end of this game, I should have 0 kills and probably like 30 to 40 deaths. But I'll probably be like probably third or fourth person on my team at best. You'll see why. What we're gonna do is jump out of here, and I'm gonna switch off of my incendiary grenades, which I forgot I had on. A very important part of the combat medic is throwing out copious amounts of smoke grenades. Yeah, that's the answer. Because that means I can fucking heal people up. No, don't you dare go away yet. Aw, you idiot. Yeah. So you can kill people with the syringe. Probably should have mentioned that. Didn't do it, of course. Missed that kill. So you have to charge it up. And so right there, I had started the charge, and that was a scout. I probably could have gotten the kill if I really wanted to. But I realized, oh yeah, the whole point of this thing was to not kill things. Oh, you assholes. So I could actually probably run around with, just, you know, my syringe out and my gas mask on. Basically be fucking invulnerable to most of the shit that will hurt you in this. Don't worry, friends. I'll lead the way. Hi. They don't really care about me because I'm not shooting at them. Hi. See? Come on. Look at me. Idiot. These guys are blind. Oh my god. Here. It's amazing. In all the time I've played this game, it's 96 hours or so now, I have never seen a group of people not respond to the fact that I'm here. Where are you? I'm not getting any revives. These guys are canceling out. So when you die in this game, you can hold the space bar. And you've seen me do it now a couple of times. And what you'll do is you'll skip your revival period. Which is helpful sometimes, but when I'm doing what I'm doing, not very helpful at all. Hey, this guy needs help. Oh, look. That guy ran into one of my med packs down there. Welcome back. Oh, more friends. Hi. Oh, that was a shotgun. So how we doing? Oh, we're back. No, I get it. Fuck you. I know we're playing nice and all, but I win. No, don't go away. Oh, shit. Well, at least those guys are covered in smoke now, so they can't see me. So you only have 3 heals, or 3 revives, before you actually have to hold off for a second and let them regenerate. This was something that was actually added to the game after release. Oh, I just caught fire. It's okay, this guy's back now. We have lost him. Why am I still on fire? So, that was a pretty good run. Where are we? 8th on the team. 2 deaths, no kills. I do have, what, just about 80 points from from hitting people with needles. I've actually gotten quite a few revive kills in the last few weeks. Hey, this guy needs some help. Or not. Fine. I don't want to help him anyways.
We have taken objective dust.
Not good. Hey, don't shoot, don't shoot. Friendly. Nope.
Taken objective butter.
Honestly, I expected to die, like 30 to 40 times by now. Like, you know, I said 40 times over the course of the game, but I don't know if that's gonna happen. They're gonna get their train soon. Oh. Oops. I got killed by a flare gun. That guy must have nailed me straight in the face.
We have lost objective butter.
That's sad. There was a dead person right in front of me, too. You'll notice me jumping through that revive screen, and that's mostly because if there's no medics near me when I go down, there's very, very low chances that they're going to show up afterwards. Here. Yep. There you go. Hey, friends.
We have lost here. Objective Edward.
Just throw that in there. So yeah, you can get pretty high up with this shit. Let's do this. Hey. There we go. Get myself set on fire. Just really looking for someone to revive. So what's happening right now in the map? Oh, it looks like they've back-capped us. Our entire team's way too far forward, and that's led to some issues. So we're gonna... Oh my god, there must be like 50 of them down there. There you go, friend. This means good things for me, because I can revive and heal. So I'm gonna get some points. Thanks. That's nice of you. I should really put that onto a, like a macro key or something. On fire again. A really nice thing about being a medic is that you can heal yourself. Get up. I'm not done yet. Oh, he's way over here. Come on, there we go. There we are. Everything works out for everybody. Ah, they're on top of it now. Good news is... Oh, hold on. Friendlies... Oh, he's up top. Hold on. Gotta go say hi. So, yeah, I wish one of the scouts down there had maybe fired off a flare or two instead of me running up there thinking that maybe they went away, but should have known better. Oh well. Nothing to it. I got 3 revives out of that life. Yeah, you can see my score is not diminishing by any means. Friendlies! Buddies, here. These guys are not sticking still enough for me to throw packs at them all the time. Now, one of the advanced, if you want to call it that, strategies that is capable of being used in this game to... Ooh, hey, don't you go anywhere. To increase your healing speeds is to... Whoa! It's like fucking Christmas in here. Come on back. More friends. So you can throw down... Whoa, did I get him? Nah, didn't get him. That's too bad. You can throw down both the bandage bags that I'm throwing out to people and also the medical boxes and get... Oh shit, I should have let that guy get me back up. Generally after like 20 seconds, if nothing's coming, nothing's ever coming. So it's not really a point to... Just, you know, stick around and wait. Hey guys, don't do this, don't do that. Oh, you prick! I'm here for you, friends. Yeah, that guy didn't last very long. So, the real point of using the medic, I should really point out to those of you who are not Battlefield familiar, is to be able to revive people because if you look at the top middle of the screen now, right up here, you'll see I have 390 over here and 319 over here. So every time they get a kill, that adds to their score, and, well, it doesn't do anything to our score, really, but it adds to their score, which is bad because we want to have the highest score because we want to prove that we're better. And so, oh man, so that is a flamethrower. I don't want none of that. Here, you have this. No! Yes! Don't you dare hit the button. How the fuck did you pull that off? These guys are probably getting really angry with me at this point. I have not fired a single shot all game. Oh no! Oh, damn. God damn. Get back. There we go. One of the things about the gas mask that I continuously put on as soon as I spawn in is that, if you happen to be wearing the gas mask, you can't really, you don't get the images around the outside of your vision that tells you how much damage you've taken, or gives you a rough idea, I guess, of it. So I'm always, no matter how much health I have, going to look like I have basically full health on my screen. So I have to go look to see if I've lost anything in the bottom right there. I don't mind that, because, you know, there should be penalties for wearing this thing that allows you to avoid getting gassed all the time. Because gas is such a huge part of how this game plays. No. Come on back. Woohoo. Here. You, me, everyone else, just hang out in this little corner. Get back. And I stayed alive long enough that I can get revived again. Let's see if that happens here. Ooh, it looks like it's going to. Continue the revive train. Even though we have very few people left in here, we're really making a fucking stand. This is kind of great. So I am just gonna stick here. I'm gonna fill people's health back up. That guy just got absolutely fucked, and I'm a coming friend. You're always gonna be able to come back to life around me. Kidding? Throw some more smoke down there, shall we? We have taken objective Duff. It looks like my team is doing pretty well, by the way. I don't know if you can really tell based on the numbers we've got going here. I'm gonna come out here to see if I can help this guy. Oh, I am on fire again. Entertainingly, I'm also going to die. Yeah, there we go. So the reason I go prone when I'm on fire, even in the middle of fire, is mostly because it will put the fire out. Very helpful. But if you happen to be sitting in fire at the time, like a goddamn Buddhist monk in Vietnam, not as good. Let's see how the map looks. We have D almost. We need E back. I'm sure there's some use of me here. Looks like it's going pretty well. We do want to hold on to C at the very least. Because you see, C is kind of sort of the crux point on this map. If you don't hold that, you're kind of screwed.
We have taken objective Edward.
And if you do hold it, well, then it's one of those hold at all cost points, and you have to be very careful about that. So what a lot of people end up doing is they'll try to go around the back of the map instead of taking C, which is what's been happening to us, why we have to continuously cap D and E again. Because the enemy is just going, well, fuck going to C, I'm gonna go around you guys. You know, the fighting isn't too intense. Alright. Looks like we're on our way here at D, though. Oh boy, there's a lot of them. There's kind of a lot of them. Hold on. Get back! I'm still alive. Hey. That guy didn't last very long. That guy probably won't last very long either. The one that just rushed in there screaming. That was a bayonet charge he was on. Alright, let's see here. Well, that's a bad guy. Hi. Come on, I want to be friends. I know I said I wouldn't get any kills, but I never said I wouldn't, you know, get some points off the stabbing with a syringe thing. That is one of my favorite things to do in this game, by the way. If you have a syringe out and you're just near somebody and you can just syringe them to death, yeah, that's pretty great. Looks like there's some friends fighting. There we go. Let's put on our... Ooh, you need help. Get back here. I'm going to throw you medical packs. There you go. You're back. The fun thing about medic packs and, of course, the ammo packs for the support class in this game is that you can just hit a single button, the Q button, and throw them to your teammates. So instead of having to go, oh boy, this is going to suck. I can hear the snipers already. Yeah, there's the one. Luckily, snipers are goddamn useless, so I'll just be able to walk right away. Look at that! In the middle of the fucking lion's den. Didn't even get fucking hit more than once. These guys suck. This enemy team is bad, and the score is just at the point where I think we're gonna see a behemoth soon. An enemy armored train. Fucking yeah! Now I kind of wish I was doing this post-com, because then I wouldn't sound like I... Well, okay. So anyways, behemoth means I am effectively useless as a medic, which is actually fine because I'm not really playing medic so much as I'm playing guy with a syringe who likes to stab things with syringe that makes him come back to life. Kind of the exact opposite of a medic. Oh, no. I guess that's exactly what a medic is. I don't know anymore. Objective Edward. Yes, friends to revive. My desire to get points and be part of the, you know, team effort is pretty fucking high in this game, no matter what. So, even as I'm trying to get revives to get on top of the scoreboard, and I'm at 7 now, I really want to make sure that we win the game, because otherwise it just looked bad. You know, go through all this effort to run around with nothing but a syringe, and my team just loses. Wouldn't look good. Looked like I was being a little selfish to do internet videos, you know? Okay, dude, I'm taking off this gas mask for a couple seconds so you stop breathing like that. Where is their train? Oh, it's still on the other end of the map. That sea bridge right there, that one? That's gonna be ugly. You're breaking off! This guy was actually setting out mines for the train, which is good news. Those mines will do a fair bit of damage. What you really should do is get on the field gun and start gunning those things down. And look, dead bodies. Yes, of course. So sorry about the breathing of Darth Vader stuff that's going to happen for a few minutes here. We are losing objective Charlie. Don't need that. So we're losing C now, mostly because the train is on it. So, oh, there's the train. That guy has 3 service stars with the train. That is not the sign of a very good player. I don't think I've been inside the train. No, I haven't. Holy shit. Be back. We do not want to stay here. We do not want to stay here. The train has got us in its sights. That's bad. Let's see. Here, friend. Don't worry, you'll come back. Oh. I thought that was a bad guy that jumped down in front of me. I was actually thinking about breaking my play nice rule for a second there to take him out. Oh, man. You get near fire in this game, you're going up like... Alright. See? Oh, you pricks! I am 2 inches away. I'm gonna revive you. Just wait the wealth of a second it takes for me to get to you sometimes. I think this guy that he's crawling, or he's actually below me somewhere. Thinking it's the latter. He's getting away. It does not take long for me to revive somebody when I get there.
Yeah, man, erste Hilfe.
If you're willing to wait the 2 seconds it takes me to get there, you will be back in no time flat. What can we do else? We took C back while they have the train out. They might not be very good. Which is actually something I theorized on earlier. There you go. Oh shit, how'd you take more damage? There we go. Keep the healing going. Ooh, look at all these bodies. Don't you go away. You are dicks. Hey. Ah, I got the revive. Fuck you. I don't know what happened after that, but I got stabbed while reviving, so that's really all I needed to see. I hope this guy stays alive just long enough for me to get in there again. These guys absolutely love their gas. Give them that. Ooh, we're losing E and D. Or just D. We're taking B, so I'm okay with that. Don't do it.
Losing objective Charlie.
Be back. Taking B. This means that there will be bodies. There will be healing opportunities like this one. Thank you. Oop. That didn't go well. Let's see where this goes. Is that the guy I just revived? Because if so. No! Sorry. I honestly felt like I needed to show that off before the end of the match, and we're fast approaching that point. I love killing people with syringes. So I kind of broke my primary goal in this video, which was to only play nice, but let's face it, that guy was not a very nice... Okay, fuck it, two of them. Aw. That guy wasn't a very nice person when you think about it. He straight on murdered a man with a club right in front of me. So I feel like that's probably an okay thing to have done. Oh, getting shot at. Objective death. There's a lot of guys here. Like, for example, that guy who just threw a grenade at me. Alright, I'm getting some points off healing. Basically, just doing good works. Outside of the one syringe kill. Or I like to imagine the guy didn't feel any pain whatsoever. It was just like a nice medicinal hug, you know? Rather not get grenades thrown at me constantly, thanks. That's a friendly flamethrower, so I don't need to worry about that one too much. Seventh on the team, 1-14. I'm probably... there's probably enough time to get a few more points. Here, friend. Enjoy healing. Wait for it. Ah, he died. So, true story, if you die on equipment like that guy did, then you actually cannot be revived. And if you get stabbed and they go through the full animation for it, you cannot get revived. So, there are a few people I can't fix back up. And of course, if somebody takes two deaths quickly off of... Oh, man.
Taking objective apples.
That was shit. Who else needs it? There you go.
We have lost objective button.
So, yeah, there's a couple of situations. If they die too fast, you can't revive them. No, no, get out of the way. This guy needs to come back. Huh. I'm so deep in the fog, or the smoke I threw down, that they can't see me reviving everybody against them in here. I'm pretty sure that guy is happy I revived him, not sad that he got blown up twice in a row. That guy has 6 service stars with dynamite. That guy plays this game a lot. We're almost at the end here. That's fine. Yeah, we're done. All that's really left to do is one more revive. Oh, sure. So, let's see how we did, shall we? I think I'm gonna be the reviver, or at least the healer for this game. Minutes. That was a relatively quick game of Battlefield. Alright. And... bam. 38 revives. Ah, come on. Come on. And no battle pack. However, we can go into the squad and personal items. I had 6 flags captured, okay. Yeah, and I had the best flags captured in the entire game. So I would say, based on my KDR ratio for this video, that we played pretty nice here. And that was really the whole point of this. Thanks for watching.